You asked me for an object that represented a pivotal part of my life, so I ask you the same.
I'll tell you, I am really nervous about this because I have never even talked about this. And I'm nervous about what's going to come out of my mouth. Yeah. So these are my father's shoes. And I keep these shoes in the trunk of my car.
Really?
And he died 17 years ago, and I've always kept these in the trunk of my car. When he died, I took his shoes and I put it in the trunk of my car, and I've never taken them out of the car until today. They mean a lot to me.
Why do you keep them in the trunk of the car? Why do you keep them in your car?
Because if I put them in a closet or something, I wouldn't see it as much as in the trunk of the car, and it's where I initially put it. And for some reason, it just connects with me that when I go into the trunk, which I do, I see my dad's shoes.
Right.
And it means a lot.
So tell me about your dad. Why?
I can tell you partly because of the shoes. If you notice in the shoes, they're different. Mm-hmm. This shoe is a different shape, and it's bigger. And it's because he had an operation when he was a kid, and one leg was longer than the other. Mm-hmm. So he had a rough time, and he had a rough life. He owned a liquor store, and he really struggled. And, you know, again, I was telling you that in some ways I see parallels in our lives. One of the parallels I saw, my dad was the hardest working person I've ever been around in my life. And he worked 16-hour days, 7 days a week. And like you and your dad, my dad really gave me my work ethic. Mm-hmm. And it's one of the most valuable tools I have in my life. Mm-hmm. I've never talked about that.
Would he be surprised that you value those so much and use them as a trigger to keep you focused?
Yeah, because they didn't mean anything. You know, it meant something to me when he put them on. And it reminded me, but I don't think he would have seen this as this really significant object. Wow, this is tough. Yeah. It's easier being on this side.
Yeah. No, well, listen, I had a great time doing it. I'm proud that you included me in the show. I appreciate it.
I am so honored that you did this, and I really mean it. I mean, just knowing what you've done with your life and knowing how you've done the twists and the turns. And by the way, I want to say one other thing, that we had talked when we did the show about a lot of times you just don't get people saying thank you for things and the things you do. This man is so appreciative of Oprah Winfrey. There is a reverence with Oprah. And you know what, though? It is unusual to know, especially, you know, he's done the show for 16 years, he's successful in his own right. He has never forgotten that, and the reverence he showed to Oprah Winfrey was really special and moving, and I walked away being really impressed by that.
Yeah, she's special. Harvey, thanks for having me on.
Thank you so much.